Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. Right off the bat, I want to apologize if the quality of the video is not up to par. My MacBook Pro is having some problems, so I'm not able to edit my videos like I have been doing in the past. So I'm shooting this video today on my iPhone XR, and hopefully the quality comes through okay and the volume is okay as well. Nevertheless, I'm trying to get you guys consistent content. I made that commitment to you guys and I want to keep my commitment. So we'll make the video with what we got. Well, what I want to talk about today is if I had to start from zero with no money, what would I do in order to build my net worth, build my income, and put myself in a position to be able to do some of the things that I would want to do from a financial standpoint? I know some guys have asked me, hey man, if you had to start all over, walk me through what you would do in order to put yourself back in a position where you were financially free again. And that's what I want to talk with you guys about today on this video. Now, keep in mind, guys, this is just my opinion. There are a lot of opinions out there in this world, and what I'm about to share with you is just my opinion. I think it would be the right approach for me, but your approach might be different. What I would ask you, though, is as you sit through and listen to me talk on this video, think about your own situation. Think about what you would do if you had to start from zero. Some of you guys may think you're at zero, so this may be helpful. But again, the information that I try and put on these videos are for you guys to just get a thought process going. A lot of times it's not meant to say, hey, this is the only way to do it. It's really meant to stimulate your mind and get you thinking about your own situation and thinking about some ways you can either take your situation financially to the next level, or if you're a young person just starting out, can give you some quick little nuggets that you can grab a hold to and say, okay, that's how I want to get started to help myself get to my financial freedom or whatever financial situation you want to be in your life. Now, the number one thing I would do if I was starting over and didn't have anything, I'd find me a job. Now, I know, you know, finding a job, a 9-to-5 is really not the popular thing to do, I guess, in today's society. But I'm a little older than most of you guys, so I'm kind of old school. And I was always taught hard work never hurt anybody. And that hard work typically starts with a 9-to-5 job. So that's what I would do. I mean, I know some of you guys would start businesses. Some of you guys would do all kind of things that you're good at or you believe you're good at. But for me, it would start with trying to get me a baseline. And having that 9-to-5 job would be that baseline, because what I would want to do with that 9-to-5 income is be able to, one, start taking care of my basic needs, shelter, food, clothing, etc. And then what I would want to do is start to take a part of that 9-to-5 income and start saving it, so that I could start building up a little bit of a nest egg, so that I could start investing in other things out there, like real estate, for instance. I'd wanna save some money so that I could start investing small and then graduate my investing to a larger extent as my money would permit me to. So that's the first thing I would do, get that 9-to-5 job, take care of my basic necessities, and then I would start saving money out of that 9-to-5 income in hopes of at some point when I got enough money saved up that I could take that money and invest it in something that would create more income for me. And again, for me, the second thing I would do is once I got that nest egg built up, I would go into real estate. And the reason I say real estate is, in my opinion, real estate is one of the fastest ways to build your net worth, to increase your net worth quickly. Now, it's not easy getting savings together in order to invest in a piece of real estate, but it certainly will exponentially increase your net worth once you start investing in real estate if you do it properly. Now, there are some ways you can invest in real estate that I've talked about in prior videos with little or no cash. So I would ask you guys to go check out the channel and check out that video I did, how to get started in real estate with little or no cash. But what I would do is, like I've given you guys advice through Instagram DMs and also when you drop comments down in the comment box on the videos, the first thing I would do is I'd find people in my community who have been very successful at real estate. Now, you can do that through real estate networking groups. You can do that through real estate investment groups. You can even go to your local realtors association and perhaps even get your real estate license. At least you'll know the mechanics of how real estate works, buying and selling. That's what I would do until you save up enough money to be able to make your own investment. Now, like I've talked about in previous videos, I purchased my first real estate property when I was 26. So of course, if I had to start over from zero, that would be the very thing I would do. I would raise enough money to be able to put a down payment on a home that I could buy for me. And then I would take that home, live in it for 2 years, and hopefully I buy it in a good growing area, and then it would appreciate in value. And then what I would do after it appreciated in value to make sure I continue moving up that ladder in real estate investing, I would then take the equity out of that property and buy me a second property, and then I would rent out that first property. That's the way I would do it. Just like I've done it in the past, I would do it the same way if I had to start from zero. I would do it the exact same way. I'd live in the house for 2 years. I'd extract all the equity out of the property. I would buy me a second property, and then I would lease that first property, and I would move into that second property. And I would repeat that process until I had a big enough nest egg that I could then go and start buying properties the old-fashioned way, which is just basically going out, finding a property, putting your down payment down, going to get financing, and then leasing that property out for income. So real estate would be the second thing I would do. The third thing I would do is I would continue exploring ways to make more income. I would not rest on my laurels. I would not just say, okay, my 9-to-5 is paying me great money. Okay, I got a couple real estate properties. I would always be pushing the envelope, always be looking for alternative ways to make additional income. I know you guys know I've talked a lot about my eBay store of recent, and that's because, guys, that's an absolutely low-cost way to be able to make money. It really is. And the first thing I would do is I'd set up that eBay store, and then I would start looking for items that I could put on that store, low-cost items that I could put on my eBay store that I could sell for a profit. Now, you can go to the, you know, carport sales, you can go to yard sales, you can go to flea markets, you can go to places like Goodwill, you can go to other thrift stores in your area. I mean, it's unlimited the places you can go find low-cost merchandise like electronics, books, all types of things like that, games. You can find those types of things right in your local area. That's what I would do. I would create a third channel of income through that eBay store, and I would just continue building it and continue building my income. Guys, it works. I've done it. So I'm not telling you guys things that I haven't done. And then the fourth thing that I would do is I would continue to focus on helping others. That would be my fourth thing I would do, because I'm a big believer in the more you give, the more you get back. So if I want to continue building my wealth, I want to continue building my net worth, my income, I think a portion of yourself or a portion of that experience that you've developed over the years, you got to give it back to other people so that they can also have an opportunity at the American dream and build their net worth and build their fortune and have financial freedom. So those are the four things I would do, guys, if I had to start from zero and rebuild my financial life. I'd start with a great 9-to-5 job. And I know some of you guys don't like that, and that's okay. I would say in your situation, then find you a business to start if you don't like the 9-to-5 route. Like I said, I'm old school, so 9-to-5 is something that I'm used to. But I know in today's world, less and less people are doing the 9-to-5 thing, and they're just creating their own business, which is cool as well. But do something to earn a primary source of income. That's the key, primary source of income, to take care of your basics. And then from there, carve out a piece of that primary income and start saving it so you can build a nest egg to be able to invest in something that's gonna generate income for you. In my case, my second thing I would do is real estate. I'd get into real estate. If I didn't have enough money, I'd get around people who know a lot about real estate and I can do things for that they may let me in on the deal. I would figure out a way how to get in real estate even if I didn't have any cash, guys. That's perseverance. It is key when it comes to real estate, especially if you don't have a lot of cash. And then number three, additional streams of income through eBay stores, through luxury watch sales like I've done in the past. There are a million things out there you can do, guys, to generate additional income. So that's the third thing. And then the fourth thing, give back. I would give back information to others so that others can follow that blueprint or pick and choose from that blueprint things that work for them so that they can go increase their financial net worth and chase their financial freedom. So that's it, guys. Those are the four things I would do if I had to start from zero with no money. That's what I would do. I hope the video was helpful, guys. I just try and make sure I have some dialogue with you guys. Drop me some comments if you guys have any thoughts on that. What would you do if you had to start from zero? Would it be a 9-to-5? Would it be your own business? What would you do in order to get that baseline primary income started in order to put you on your journey to successful and financial freedom? Drop me some comments and let me know. If you guys want to have a more of a dialogue, direct dialogue, you can always DM me on Instagram at RichardFain28. All right, guys. Well, thank you again for stopping by the channel, checking out this video. I hope it was helpful. If you're stopping by the channel for the first time, please consider subscribing and share the video. Give me a thumbs up as well. It helps the channel and it helps me as well. But as always, guys, keep chasing greatness, and I will catch you.